This is part four in our series of the Introduction to Financial Accounting, Terms, Principles, and the Accounting Equation. And in this part, we're going to be looking at the financial statements and what makes up those financial statements and how those financial statements are related. So let's first look at the income statement. The income statement is the first statement you have to create. And there's a reason for that, and we'll see that in just a second. But we're looking at Smart Touch Learning Incorporated. So the first thing I want us to take note of is the title. The title of the statement is imperative so that your readers know what statement they're looking at. So let's look at the parts of the title. The first thing in the title is the name of the company. Underneath the name of the company comes the name of the financial statement, in this case, the income statement. And then the third line of the title is the time period covered. Now you'll see with the income statement, it actually is a period of time. For example, in this one, it's the month ended, April 30th, 2010. It could be quarter ended. It could be year ended. But note that the income statement is for a period of time. Now let's look at the parts of the income statement. The income statement contains two parts, the revenues and expenses. You subtract your expenses from your revenues to get net income or net loss if expenses exceed the revenues. Revenues cause increases in retained earnings from delivering goods and services to customers. Expenses cause decreases in retained earnings resulting from operations. So if we subtract our expenses, in this case, from our revenues, we do get a net income because our revenues exceed our expenses. So we get net income of $5,200. Well, now let's look at the statement of retained earnings. Again, look at the title here. Three lines in the title. Very similar to the income statement title. The statement of retained earnings also covers a period of time. For example, month ended in this case. It could be quarter ended, year ended, but it's a period of time. Now look how these two statements are related. We calculated net income in the income statement above of $5,200. Remember, retained earnings is affected by net income, and you can see how in this statement of retained earnings. So we take our net income from the income statement and bring it down to the statement of retained earnings. We add that to our beginning retained earnings, then subtract our dividends. Remember, dividends is not an expense. That's why it does not appear on the income statement. Dividends is just a payment to our owners for their investment. It's not an expense. It reduces the retained earnings, the owner's claims on the assets, part of owner's equity. So once you subtract dividends, you're left with your ending retained earnings. In this case, $3,200. The third financial statement we will produce is the balance sheet. Now, something you should see very familiar about the balance sheet is that's the accounting equation. Assets equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity. So the $3,200 that we got in our ending retained earnings from the statement of retained earnings, we will move down to the stockholders' equity section in our balance sheet as our retained earnings amount. Then we add up all of our assets. All of our assets should equal our liabilities plus our stockholders' equity. And in this case, it does. One thing I want you to pay particular note to is the title of the balance sheet. The balance sheet is kind of the oddball when it comes to the title of the statement. Very similar, but notice the date. It is not for a period of time. It's as of a specific day in time. So the balance sheet is a snapshot of a company's financial position. So what are the assets as of today? What are our liabilities as of today? It doesn't cover a period of time. It's as of this date in time. The fourth and final financial statement is called the Statement of Cash Flows. Notice its title is exactly like the income statement and the statement of retained earnings. Again, the balance sheet is the only oddball. It's the only one that does not cover a period of time. The Statement of Cash Flows contains three sections: the Operating Activities section, the Investing Activities section, and the Financing Activities section. And those three sections combined gives you your net increase or decrease in cash. In this case, we have a net increase in cash of $19,900. Notice our beginning cash balance down at the bottom as of April the 1st, 2010, was zero. If you add your beginning cash to the net increase in cash, you get your ending cash balance as of April the 30th, 2010, of $19,900. If you note, you have a check figure for this statement. That $19,900 is exactly the cash amount that appears on the balance sheet. That's your ending cash balance.